Welcome to the demo, Install the First Cluster. I'm Andrea Angiolillo and I'm working in the Ops Manager team. In this demo, I'm going to show you how to deploy a cluster using Ops Manager. First of all, you will need a server running Ops Manager. Ops Manager is the management platform on MongoDB that allows you to deploy, monitor, backup, and scale MongoDB on your own infrastructure. In this demo, we will be running Ops Manager on port 8080. This is how users and agents will be able to interact with Ops Manager. Beside the web server, Ops Manager needs a MongoDB database to store metadata. Once Ops Manager is running, we can set up a replica set. Replica set are MongoDB processes that share the same data between all the members of the set. As you may already know, they provide redundancy and high availability. For the purpose of this demo, we will be deploying a replica set with three members. In order to do so, we need to install the automation agent on each server. The automation agent is the main process used by Ops Manager to interact directly with our MongoDB processes. Each agent, in addition to being able to manage its local MongoDB process, also needs to be able to talk to any other MongoDB instance in the replica set. Another agent used by Ops Manager is the monitoring agent. This agent allows us to get useful key performance indicator of the servers running our replica set. Let's see now how to deploy a replica set with Ops Manager. This is the Ops Manager instance that I will be using for this demo. As you can see here, I define an organization, which I called Organization 0, and also a project inside this organization, Project 0. Now if I want to deploy a new replica set, I have to go inside the deployment page and select the Processes tab. Here I have to click on the New Deployment button and then select New Replica Set. In this page I'm going to see all the information that Ops Manager needs in order to create a new replica set. But before that, we need to install the automation agent. In order to do so, we have to click on the See Instructions link inside the warning message and then select the operation system of the server. Let's see now how to install the automation agent. Installing the automation agent is quite straightforward. We have just to copy and paste all the commands that we are going to find in this guide inside the terminal. The first thing to do is to download and extract the automation agent. Then, we have to generate the API key by pressing the Generate Key button. After that, we have to modify the local config file. This file contains all the information that the automation agent needs in order to communicate with Ops Manager. Here we have to provide the MMS group ID, the MMS API key, and the MMS base URL. After changing the local config file, we have also to create three different directories: the var lib MongoDB MMS automation, the var log MongoDB MMS automation, and the data. After that, we have also to ensure that all of those three directories are owned by the same user by running those three commands. We can start now our automation agent. Now that we have installed the automation agent, we can create the replica set. The first thing to do is to insert the replica set ID. Remember that this ID cannot be changed in the future. Then we have the replica set configuration. Here we can see the MongoDB process name, we can set the MongoDB server version, and the directories where the MongoDB process will be storing data and log files. Now we have the member configuration section, which allows us to configure each member of the replica set. Here we can select the member type for each MongoDB process. We can have a default member, which means that this member can vote and become a primary. An arbiter member, which means that this member cannot be elected as primary, but can vote in an election. Then we have the hidden member. This member is not visible to the client application, but can still vote in elections. Finally, we have delayed hidden. This member reflects an earlier or delayed state of the set. After selecting the member type, we have to provide the host name and the port number. For the purpose of this demo, I'm going to select the same host name for each member of the replica set. I want to point out that this is not a recommended practice. You should definitely define different host name for your members. After selecting the host name and the port number, we can insert the number of votes available for an election inside the votes column. Priority allows us to increase or decrease the likelihood that one member is going to be elected as primary. delay specify the number of seconds behind the primary this member should lag. When the property build indexes is set to true, the MongoDB process is going to use the indexes. And finally, we have the tag properties, which allow us to specify tag associated to the replica set. After member configuration, we have replication settings. Here we can specify the protocol version, which allows us to specify the replication protocol that the replica set is going to use. When the property chaining allowed is set to true, allows secondary member to replicate from other secondary members. The property write concern majority journal default specifies the behavior of the majority write concern if the journal option is not specified. Heartbeat timeout specifies the number of seconds that the replica set member wait for a successful heartbeat. Election timeout specifies the time limit for detecting when a replica set primary is unreachable. Catch-up timeout specifies the time limit for a newly elected primary to sync with the other replica set members. Catch-up takeover delay specifies the time that a node is going to wait to initiate a catch-up takeover. Finally, we have the getLastError defaults. These properties allow us to specify the default write concern for the replica set. The last section of this page is advanced configuration option. Here we can set MongoDB runtime options for each process. In order to add a new option, you have to click on the Add Option button and then select your option. After that, you are going to see your option inside the table, and here you can select different values for each process. I suggest you to click on the Learn More link to discover more about all the different configuration options. Okay, now we are ready to click on the Create Replica Set button. After that, we are going to click on the Review and Deploy. And here we are going to see all the information that Ops Manager is going to use to deploy your replica set. Let's see now how to enable the monitoring agent. In order to enable the monitoring agent, we have to go inside the deployment page and select the Servers tab. Here we are going to see the list of servers running your replica set. For each server, we have to click on the Activate Monitoring button. Then we have to click on Review and Deploy. Once Ops Manager has enabled the monitoring agent, we can go back to the Processes tab. Here we can expand the replica set, and we are going to see a list of charts, such as operations, disk per space used, and so on. We can also click on the Replica Set ID to go to the overview page. Then, if we click on the Real-Time tab, we are going to see real-time metrics related to our replica set, such as operations per second, query execution times, query targeting, and read and write. If we are interested in knowing how the replica set members are performing, we can go inside the Metrics tab. Here we can compare the different performances of the members of the replica set, and we can also select only the metrics that we are interested in. Let's see now how to enable TLS for a deployment. The first thing to do is to enable TLS for your project. In order to do so, we have to go inside the Deployment page. Then, inside the Security tab, we are going to find the Authentication and TLS. Here we have to click on the Edit Settings button. The first thing to do is to enable one or more authentication methods. For the purpose of this demo, I'm going to select the first authentication method, but you can select any of them. Then we have to configure TLS. Here we have to enable TLS and also provide the certificate authority file. This file is going to be used by the MongoDB agents to communicate with your deployment. Then we have the client certificate mode. When this property is set to optional, all the client applications need to provide the certificate in order to communicate with your deployment. When it's set to required, both the client applications and the agents need to provide the certificate in order to communicate with your deployments. Then we can configure the security settings for all the deployments in our project. This step is optional, and for now I'm going to disable the TLS mode properties. I'm going to show you in a few seconds which properties you have to set in your deployment in order to enable TLS. The last step is to configure the Ops Manager agents. Here we can provide another certificate and also the related password. Once we have finished to configure the agents, we can click on the Save button. Then we can review our changes by clicking Review and Deploy. Once we are happy, we can click on Confirm and Deploy. Okay, now that we have enabled TLS for the project, let's see how to enable TLS for our deployment. The first thing to do is to go inside the Deployment page and select the Processes tab. Here we have to click on the Modify button. Then we have to go to the Advanced Configuration options and add two different options. We have the TLS mode and also the TLS certificate key file. Here we have to set the TLS mode as require TLS and also provide the TLS certificate file for each replica set members. The TLS certificate key file contains the path where your certificate is stored in each server. Remember that if your certificate required a password, you have also to provide the property TLS certificate key file password for each of your replica set member. Once we have done that, we can click on the Save button and review our changes. Then confirm and deploy. And now we have enabled TLS for our deployment.